Daniel, you've got Antoinette Cato in there, and then later in that same reel from the first year, you talked to Donald Harrison's mother. I've forgotten her first name, sorry.
Therese Harrison.
And this isn't a film about music, obviously, right. But how did those stories kind of come about? I mean, did you consciously try to talk with folks who were connected to music, or can you talk about that a little bit?
Yeah, no, we didn't. The Harrison family has music certainly in it, but it also has the Mardi Gras Indian culture, and that was real important. I think one of the questions you raise when you say, well, how you rebuild the city is, what was the city and what will the city be? And culture turns out to be absolutely essential, I think. And what the Harrisons did particularly, but Antoinette as well, was say, if we don't have the music, if we don't have the second line, if we don't have the food, we don't have a city. And I think a lot of us think of it, certainly a lot of officials when it comes to public school budgets, think of it as an extra, right? The music and all that stuff. It turns out it's what, I don't have to tell you guys this, it's what we live and breathe, it's what we care most about. So that are among the most, and religion is another. I mean, Jonathan and I laugh, neither one of us are Christians, we end up making a Christian film. Partly because that keeps people going, you know, and the music keeps people going. And so we couldn't help Lauren but run into that, and I think it's an essential part of the story. It isn't, oh, we'll have the city back and we can make music. It's, we're gonna make music and it's gonna help rebuild the city. It's part of what's going on. That's why it was so important that there were second lines in Mardi Gras again, I think. It's that people needed to know why they were living there, what it was about.